A global catastrophic risk is a hypothetical future event which could lead to the destruction of modern civilization, mass extinction, or the destruction of the planet entirely. Earth's geological record is filled with asteroid impacts, climate shifts, ice ages, supervolcanoes, and extinction. Lots and lots of extinction. But the greatest risk to life may not come from anything terrestrial. Here are 10 of the most terrifying existential risks to life on Earth. Number 10. Warfare and weapons of mass destruction. In 1983, the Soviet Union's nuclear early warning system reported the launch of multiple USAF Minuteman intercontinental ballistic missiles from US military bases. The only thing that saved us from having our skies bathed in nuclear fire was Officer Stanislav Petrov's gut feeling that the warning was a false alarm. John F. Kennedy once estimated the odds of all-out nuclear warfare happening to be somewhere between 1 out of 3 and even. American cryptologist Professor Martin Hellman has claimed that nuclear war is actually inevitable. The United States and Russia have a combined arsenal of 14,700 nuclear weapons, and the total world supply ranges in the high 15,000s. Though Cold War studies estimate that billions of people would survive the initial conflict, the debate rages on whether or not secondary effects such as nuclear winter, radiation sickness due to fallout, and unforeseen environmental effects could contribute to the total extinction of life on Earth. A 2008 study by the Future of Humanity Institute estimated a 4% probability of extinction from warfare by 2100, with a 1% chance of extinction from nuclear warfare. Other forms of warfare, such as biological and chemical warfare, also carry their own risks, though chemical warfare has a significantly lower chance of threatening life on Earth as a whole. Number 9. Biotechnology disaster. In 2008, a survey made by the Future of Humanity Institute estimated a 2% probability for life on Earth to go extinct due to the accidental release of a biologically modified organism. The increasing accessibility of technologies which allow us to modify the characteristics of viruses and other biological agents has led to an increased risk factor that such agents could be accidentally released into our environment, having devastating effects on ecosystems that they come into contact with. In 2001, researchers attempting to sterilize rats by developing a new virus accidentally modified it instead. The modified virus became extremely volatile to the mice, even to those that had already been vaccinated. Following the rapid developments in CRISPR editing, editing of DNA sequences found in genomes of organisms like bacteria and archaea, an international summit proclaimed in December of 2015 that it was irresponsible to proceed with human gene editing until safety measures and efficacy could be addressed. Number 8. Nanotechnology. In K. Eric Drexler's 1986 book Engines of Creation, the nanotechnology pioneer outlines a terrifying scenario where the accidental creation of nanomachines that consume organic matter as a means of energy production end up devouring all life on Earth. While this idea that such an event could be accidental has been rejected by modern-day experts in the field, there is still quite a bit of existential risk with the emerging development of nanotechnologies. While there is a plethora of benefits to the development of nanotech, such as automation, medical advancement, and manufacturing, there are also risks in those same areas. It has been argued that the emergence of these technologies could lead to a new arms race. Since nanomachines are so small and factories of them could take up as little space as a small desktop, it would be incredibly difficult for governments to regulate their use or production. It has been noted that nanotech would be extremely beneficial in medical procedures, but the same could be said of warfare. Nanomachines would be capable of entering the bodies of enemy combatants or civilians without their knowledge and be just as effective at killing the subject as they would be in other medical procedures. Number 7. Artificial intelligence. Stephen Hawking, Elon Musk, and Bill Gates have argued that the rise of superintelligent machines would spell certain doom for humanity, and it all comes down to control. We're already seeing automation take hold in many industries. The robots that serve us may not be intelligent enough yet to pose a threat, but what happens when AI surpasses human intelligence? Would it see us as obsolete? Would it then seek to eradicate us? Most of you are probably thinking of Terminator-style machines or AI-controlled drones hunting humans down in the trenches of a post-nuclear wasteland. And while that is certainly a possibility, the threat could take a very different form than what's offered by Hollywood science fiction films. More and more systems are becoming becoming automated, relying on basic AI to do rudimentary things. What happens when this automation extends to medical equipment, or when computer viruses become able to self-adapt to countermeasures, or if super-intelligent machines gain the ability to build even greater artificial intelligences? Science fiction author and computer scientist Werner Vinge suggested that the moment where humanity creates an intelligence greater than itself is the very moment when the human era will end, calling it the singularity. Number 6. Mineral resource exhaustion. In the last decade, the price of helium has gone up more than 250%. One of the world's biggest supplies of the element, the Federal Helium Reserve, has seen its supply gradually depleted over the course of the last decade, and it is estimated that it will sell off its remaining supply by 2021. Helium is used in vital medical technologies, arc welding, and to pressurize liquid-fueled rockets. And while it's one of the most common elements in the known universe, it's actually extremely rare on Earth. Scientific data seems to suggest that humans are living far beyond the carrying capacity of our planet. In July 2015, the official United Nations World Population's prospects was revised, stating that the population would swell to 8.5 billion by 2030, and as of February 2020, we're currently sitting at 7.7 billion people worldwide. Due to increased demands on the Earth's resources accompanying the increase in population, scientists and researchers suggest that it is not a matter of if, but when those resources dry up. Number 5. Natural climate change. It has been proposed that at one point in the distant past, ice covered the entirety of the Earth, exterminating all life on the surface. Causes suggested for this snowball Earth have ranged from space clouds, dust and particle clouds that could have at one point blocked out the sun, a lowering of greenhouse gases, to a much dimmer sun. Ice ages dominate the majority of Earth's timeline. Interglacial periods are dwarfed by long stretches of time where the ice sheets rule the surface of the planet and can be attributed to variations in the Earth's orbit, dimming and brightening of the sun during its natural cycles and precessions, as well as extraterrestrial events such as cataclysmic bombardment by asteroids, which can drastically increase the Earth's temperature. The average duration of an interglacial period is around 10,000 years. The last ice age was more than 11,000 to 17,000 years ago. It's worthy to note that a modern ice age would have a drastic effect on human civilization. It would disturb many industries, shrink usable lands for crops, and it's possible that such an event would cause civilization to implode entirely. To exactly what extent, though, that's debatable. What isn't debatable, however, is that if another snowball Earth scenario were to happen in modern times, all life on the surface of the Earth would likely go extinct. Number 4. Extraterrestrial invasion. While there is no current evidence to support the existence of extraterrestrial life, many prominent astronomers and scientists, like Carl Sagan, have suggested that it is highly likely. And in 1969, the Extraterrestrial Exposure Law was added to the US Code of Federal Regulations in response to the possibility of biological contamination resulting from the Apollo program. While unlikely, it is possible that if extraterrestrial life exists, it could find us and invade the Earth, thereby exterminating and replacing human life, stealing our resources, terraforming the planet to serve their own needs, enslaving us, or just destroying the planet altogether. Stephen Hawking suggested that we should be wary about answering messages from potential alien civilizations. If such a civilization were to view us as inferior, and if they were far more technologically advanced, there's no telling what they might be able to do to us. Number 3. Cosmic threats. In April 2008, it was announced that two simulations of long-term planetary movement, one at the Paris Observatory and the other at the University of California, Santa Cruz, indicate a 1% chance that Mercury's orbit could be made unstable by Jupiter's gravitational pull sometime during the lifespan of the Sun. If this were to become a reality, the simulations suggested a collision with Earth could be one of four possible outcomes. And if that were to happen, then all life on Earth would be wiped out. Period. Last year, we took the first ever photo of a black hole at the center of a galaxy, M87, and it's theorized that smaller black holes are fairly common in the universe. Recently, ALMA, Atacama Large Millimeter-Submillimeter Array, a set of 66 telescopes scattered across the Atacama Desert in northern Chile, thought they might have discovered a wandering black hole about the mass of Jupiter in our galaxy. It's thought that wandering black holes are rare, but if such a black hole were to wander into our solar neighborhood, the effects would be disastrous. Then there's the possibility possibility of gamma ray bursts frying the Earth, vacuum decay causing the conversion of our universe to a lower energy state at the speed of light, destroying everything we love without any forewarning, massive solar flares or solar storms that could cook us, and inevitably the gradual expansion of the sun's radius into a red giant where it comes to dominate our sky and boil our oceans if it doesn't consume the planet entirely. Luckily, that last one isn't going to happen for billions of years. If that doesn't make you feel like an insignificant piece of stardust, well, I don't know what will. Number 2. Asteroid Impact. 66 million years ago, the Chicxulub asteroid slammed into the Earth, killing the dinosaurs and causing the Earth's global temperature to rise by 5 degrees Celsius, a change that persisted for 100,000 years. Recently, the Chelyabinsk meteor exploded over Russia with a blast that was stronger than a nuclear explosion, injuring around 1,200 people. Scientists often describe our solar system as a shooting gallery, and it should be no shock that NASA has discovered well over 15,000 documented near-Earth objects. The most troubling of all of these may be Atira asteroids, which is a class of asteroid which orbit too close to the Sun to be easily detected. Such an asteroid, named LF6, is a world-ending object that has the fastest known orbit of any object in our solar system. Its orbit also intersects Venus's, and it is possible that interactions with Venus's gravity could one day alter the asteroid's orbit, sending it on a collision course with the Earth. What's most terrifying about the possibility of an asteroid hitting the Earth is that there's no viable plan to divert or destroy a planet ender. Nuclear weapons have in the past been proposed, but new research suggests that not only would nukes be largely ineffective, but they could actually make the situation worse by breaking up a massive asteroid into lots of large chunks. Number 1. Environmental Disaster. The Holocene extinction is the sixth mass extinction event, and it's ongoing, measuring the mass die-offs of mammals, birds, amphibians, reptiles, arthropods and plants at a rate of 100 to 1,000 times faster than previously established natural background rates. Some of these mass extinctions have been attributed to the hunting patterns of early humans as they expanded their numbers, as the extinctions do match up with the steady growth of human populations and the rise of civilization. However, there is some debate as to how much human hunting activity contributed to the extinction of megafauna and massive land mammals like the woolly mammoth. One of the contributing factors could be climate change and ocean acidification. Ocean acidification is known as global warming's ugly twin. For nearly 200 years, the ocean has absorbed more than 150 billion metric tons of carbon from human activities, resulting in a record lowering of the average pH level of ocean waters. Risks associated with more acidic oceans include the extinction of biologically diverse habitats such as coral reefs and marine life. And then there's colony collapse disorder. Measured in the early part of the 21st century, CCD is a phenomenon that occurs when almost all the worker bees in a colony vanish, leaving behind a queen, plenty of food, and a few nurse bees to care for the remaining immature bees. Bees help to pollinate 35% of the world's food sources, and current estimates suggest that 25% of bumblebees in the US are at risk of extinction. Habitat loss, pesticide use, and disease are thought to be causing the decline. Environmental disasters like these could very well be accelerating the mass extinction of life on Earth, and scientists give us a decade to solve the problem before we cross the point of no return. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. Do not forget to subscribe, brand new videos from me every day of the week. Also, why not check out another channel I do called Geographics? It's a geography-based channel. Gonna link to that below. And thank you for watching.